video, we look at non-invasive blood pressure measurement. First of all, we'd like to establish the basic requirements that we need to be able to carry out a reliable measurement. We will then show you how it works, and at the end, we will also go into a little more detail about the extra features that we have in the corpuls3T.
For a measurement that is as error-free as possible, it is important that we rule out some technical factors that can falsify the measurement, especially artifacts. Artifacts arise when the patient moves, for example, when wearing a cuff, or when there are movements in the tubing, or when the monitor is not sitting stably or is moved around. The patient should be informed about the procedure. As already mentioned, we have chosen the correct blood pressure cuff size. If possible, the patient should not talk during the measurement and should be in a sitting or lying position. Because of an oscillometric, i.e. automatic, measurement depends on influencing factors. We recommend doing the first measurement manually. For this, we have a manometer, which can be easily connected to all common corpuls3T cuffs.
After creating the right conditions and explaining to the patient what we are about to do, we select the correct cuff size. Here it is really helpful to take advantage of the range index. I simply take a cuff, correctly place it on the patient's bare arm, and close it. What we see here is that the white index stripe is within the range indicated by the arrows above. I also have a distance of about 2 centimeters to the elbow and the artery. If I were to feel it now, it would be here.
To give you a bit of an idea of what cuff sizes are available, we have laid out 3 reusable cuffs, with the focus on the most used cuffs. In the middle and immediately recognizable is the cuff that Verena applied earlier, the adult. There are obviously also larger ones, and this one here is a slightly smaller cuff for children. We are not able to show the entire portfolio here, in particular the smaller children's sizes, but of course they go down to very, very small. All the cuffs are reusable, including short-term cuffs. This means they can be used up to a maximum period of 7 days, and there are disposable cuffs for single use. These are mainly for use in infants and neonates. At this point, we would like to reiterate, please only use cuffs approved for the device. And now I would suggest that we take a measurement.
To measure the blood pressure, we first open the NIBP menu by selecting the corresponding field. Here I have the option to set the initial inflation pressure. I can use the mode button to select the patient's age group. Automatic initial inflation pressures are stored for this. Or I can also set the initial inflation pressure myself by turning the wheel and confirming it with a push. This especially makes sense if I find that there is a strong deviation, the manual measurement to the initial inflation pressure that has already been set. Now I can specify that the initial inflation pressure should be 20 to 30 millimeters Hg above the measured pressure. I can also activate an interval by pressing auto and then changing the interval time to an interval field next to it.
The device has now measured the blood pressure and displays it together with the calculated mean value. Here we can also see 3 stars. This is a kind of measurement quality index. It's algorithm-based. The more stars, the more valid the measurement is from a technical point of view. At 0 to 1 stars, we recommend repeating the measurement if possible.
What you can also see here is the RMT icon. This means the RMT is active, which is automatically the case as soon as I have also performed a basic ECG on the patient. Here, the R peaks of the ECG are compared with the pulse waves from the blood pressure measurement, which can improve the quality of the measurement, and artifacts on the blood pressure side can be filtered out. However, if there are too many artifacts in ECG, for example, during transport, the blood pressure measurement would be unnecessarily long. In that case, I would disable RMT. To do so, I exit the large blood pressure menu. You see here in the parameter field, the RMT is active. Go to the menu, click on NIBP, select settings, and uncheck RMT active at the bottom. Confirm the whole thing with OK. You can already see here in the parameter field that the RMT symbol has disappeared, which means it is deactivated.
We just showed you the blood pressure measurement on the corpuls3T. The core element of the video was to enable you to take a valid measurement. We discussed the importance of a manual initial measurement, Then we discussed choosing the right cuff size, and we were able to give you a bit of an overview of which cuffs are available. Verena led us through the blood pressure menu and explained the individual parameters, and then I explained the quality index. Verena explained the advantages and limitations of the RMT. We hope it was of some help to you, and we'd love to see you back here soon. Bye!